Hi, this is JP from Other Lights Over Arkham. This time in the Unexpected Courage series, we are playing Amanda Sharpe and trying out the Innsmouth Conspiracy deluxe box with the two core sets. And let's see which kind of deck we could build with that limited cardpool for Amanda. So, Amanda is really focused in having a lot of skill icons to commit because her special ability is to put a card underneath her, and then you can use that card for your turn for every test, committing it, so you don't lose the card but get the benefits of that card. So naturally you want a lot of skill cards for Amanda because skill cards are designed for committing to skill tests and give you nice bonuses when you commit them. So, starting from the assets, we have something to help with the investigation. We have the cryptographic cipher and flashlight, and also I added two knives because with this limited cardpool, we really don't have any other weapon options for Amanda to use. And the stat line of 2-2-2-2 is a bit punishing if you don't have any way to boost your combat and there are enemies that you might have to fight, which we try to avoid as much as possible, but it's good to be prepared for fighting if needed. There is also two copies of magnifying glass, so we have a much heavier hand slot for investigating because we just want to investigate as fast as possible, get the clues and get out and not fight. And to support that, of course, Dr. Milan Christopher and hyper awareness. So as we're investigating a lot, we want to get Milan into play hopefully early so we can generate a lot of resources for the assets and also for the hyper awareness, so that we can evade and investigate better. Then for the events, we have two copies of barricade. This scenario has a lot of enemies, so you might need to barricade yourself to a multiple clue location for a bit before moving out, so it's nice to keep those non-elite enemies out of there as long as possible. Then we have deep knowledge, which will help us get cards and find the cards we need. Then working hunch, always really good if you have Milan to generate resources, so you can just fast grab a clue and keep moving if needed. Then there are some double clue locations in true solo for this scenario, so we added deduction, and then we have the all of the new basic skill cards from the core set. So two guts, two manual dexterities, two overpower, two perception, and two unexpected courages. Unfortunately, we hit amnesia as our basic weakness, so that with this card cycling ability of drawing cards and putting cards underneath Amanda and drawing cards if you have like a perception underneath Amanda and you're investigating three times or something like that, you are drawing a lot, so we might run into trouble with amnesia discarding our big hand, but it is what it is, and let's hope we don't get punished that much with amnesia. So, we have set up the scenario. We start in the unfamiliar chamber, as usual. It's a three-shrouded location with one clue, and there is already one face-down key on it. There are two other face-down keys, and they're green and the blue key that we need to get. And we need to find a way out of this pit some way. So, I think that is enough of the Pit of Despair scenario and Amanda's deck, so let's get started. have reshuffled the deck, and there are actually quite a lot of chaos tokens in the back in this scenario. So there are 20, two of each special symbol and the other usuals, but we will thin down the deck if we find the flashbacks that are scattered in this scenario's locations. So we draw our opening hand of 5 cards. We are looking for something to boost our investigation. So we find the cryptographic cipher, unexpected courage, then we have deep knowledge, hyper awareness, and barricade. So I think we don't need barricade right at the start. Hyper awareness and cryptographic cipher could be good. Good deep knowledge to just draw more cards. I think we just discard the barricade and keep the rest. So we draw one card and it's another hyper awareness. So I think we are putting that underneath Amanda for the first turn. We are only investigating once, so we don't want to use the unexpected courage this early. It's a really powerful card because it's a white icon, so we can use it for any skill test. So, first thing first, at the start of our turn, we draw a card. Just put my hand over here. So we draw a card. We got actually a really good card, so Dr. Milan Christopher. Then we put one card underneath Amanda, and I'll use this slot for the card that is underneath Amanda, so it's easier to see. So that is underneath Amanda. First action, we will of course play Dr. Milan Christopher, costing 4 resources. Milan boosts our intellect by 1, so now we could investigate 3, using this 4 against 3. But I think before that, for our second action, we will use deep knowledge. So we draw, add 2 curse tokens into the back. Then we draw 3 cards. So we get another Milan magnifying glass and another deep knowledge. So as a fast action, I'll use this one resource to play the magnifying glass to boost our investigative skill even more. And then we are investigating 5 versus 3. I think that might be enough because almost all of these are minus 2. So let's take a chance and investigate 5 versus 3. And it's a minus 1, so we grab this blue. And we also grab this key. And I'll keep the keys over here. So that is our whole turn, and that is our turn. No enemies. We go to upkeep. We draw one. Oh yeah, we got one resource from Dr. Milan Christopher for succeeding in the investigation test. We grab another magnifying glass, and we get one resource. So that is the first turn. Let's go to the next turn. So we add a doom. The doom threshold is 7, so we have some time before. And just a reminder, we have the floating stuff in this scenario, so if we start and end our turn in a fully floated location, we take 5 direct damage if we don't leave that location to a partially or unfloated location in between the turn. The encounter card for this turn is Riptide. If your location is unfloated, Riptide can search. So this searches. And we get fractured consciousness test. Intellect 3. If you reveal a tablet token, this automatically fails. If you fail, take 2 damage. Okay. So we are committing the hyper awareness to the test. So this doesn't give us boost for this, so we are testing 4 versus 3. It's a elder thing, it's a minus 3 if you fail, and the amalgam is in the depths, but it isn't, so we only fail it and take 2 direct damage, 2 damage, so we can split the damage, but we can't put it there because that would kill Milan, so we'll take the 2 damage. At the start of our turn, we discard this, draw a new card, and unfortunately it's the whispers from the depths, from the deep. So when choosing a card to place beneath Amanda Sharpe, it whispers from the deep is in your hand, you must choose it. So we have to put this underneath Amanda. That really sucks, because we were thinking of investigating a lot this turn. Instead, I think my first action will be just to play the hyper awareness. And second action will move to the tidal tunnel on the right. And it's a fully floated underwater cavern with one clue and only a shroud of 2, so we'll try to investigate. And I think we are not playing the cryptographic cipher this game, so because we have the other magnifying glass in hand, so I'll commit that, so we are investigating 3 versus 2. Because this is minus 1, this is plus 1. And actually this give me plus 2. So 4 versus 2. And it's a minus 2. If you fail and you control a key, take one more. Well, we didn't fail because it was a minus 2. So we grab this clue. And we get a resource that actually gives us a chance to play the other magnifying glass as a fast action. And that is our turn, so again no enemies, we go to upkeep, we draw a card, we get manual dexterity, and we gain one resource. So that is the second turn, let's go to the next turn. We add another 2. The encounter card for this turn is Deep One Assault. No Deep Ones in play, so we search the encounter deck and discard pile for Deep One enemy, spawn it, engage with us, and shuffle the encounter deck. Okay. So no Deep Ones in the encounter deck's discard, so we'll just check the deck. I think we take Lurking Deep One because it isn't a hunter. Or actually we take the Deep One Bull. Yeah, because we are not killing Deep Ones, I reckon, so we'll just try to evade it and run away. Leave it here. Not paid any attention after this. So we shuffle the counter deck back. This engages us. We'll add this token here. And when this guy engages us, we have to discard a card from our hand. Okay, and that is the Mythos phase. We go to the investigation. So at the start of the investigation phase, we draw a card, we get overpower, and we discard this, and we choose a card to put underneath here. So we'll choose the manual dexterity. And first action, we'll use that to evade the deep one bull. So we are evading 4 versus 2. I think is enough. We're not spending the hyper over yet. It's looking that we fail this and we have to try again. I'll maybe then spend a resource. It's an elder sign, so we actually double this icon. So Amanda Sharpe's elder sign ability is effect plus 0. For this test, you may double the number of skill icons on the card beneath Amanda Sharpe. So we double the agility icon, so we pass. This guy is evaded. Then I'll just put it over here. We draw a card from the manual dexterity. Another manual dexterity. Second action, we'll move over here. So now we left the fully flooded location, so we're clear. Then last action, we'll just move under here. And it's the underground river, 2 clues and a shroud of 4. So next turn we'll try to clear this location, hopefully. But that is our whole turn. And no enemy actions, we go to upkeep, so this guy readies. We draw a card. And we gain 1 resource. So that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We are 3, doom of 7. The encounter card for this turn is Memory of Oblivion. Test, willpower 4 or intellect 4. If you reveal an Elder Thing token during this test, you automatically fail. For each point you fail by, choose and discard 1 card from your hand. So I'm choosing intellect. I am 3 versus 1. I'll go 4 versus 1. I think that's fine. 4 versus 4. So let's see what we get. So this is committed. I'm actually spending these resources, so I'm 6 versus 4. And it's a minus 3, so we fail by 1, so we have to get rid of 1 card, so I'm losing the overpower. This is the least useful card from those. And actually, we have to discard 4 cards, because that was... Yeah, we lose our whole hand. That sucks quite a lot. Because, let's back up that we drew an Elder Thing, so we automatically fail, so we fail by 4. So that is really bad, actually. Well, it is what it is. At the start of the investigation phase, we discard this, draw a card, and we have to put this underneath Amanda. But that is fine, because it's an unexpected courage, so we can easily clear this location from clues. So we'll start by investigating. We have 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 versus 4. So up by 3. We succeed, we gain 1 clue and 1 resource. We'll investigate again. Up by 3. It's a 0. We grab this clue. So we have plenty of clues so far, but I think we are advancing at the start of the next turn. So last action, I'll actually just draw a card. So we get the barricade. And that is our whole turn. And no enemy actions, we go to upkeep. We draw another card, we get the knife, and we gain 1 resource. And we actually got 1 resource from. So, that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We are at 4 of 7 doom. Encounter card for this turn is Macabre Memento. Test willpower 3. If you reveal a cultist token during this test is automatically phase. If you fail, take 2 horror. So I'm using the Unexpected Courage. I'm testing 4 versus 3. I think I'm not spending anything else. It's an auto fail, so we just take 2 horror. Well, aren't we getting unlucky with all of these tests? Okay, well, it is what it is. At the start of the investigation phase, we discard this, we draw a card, and we get guts. And I think I'm just putting the knife underneath here. And be content with that. So we'll spend the clues at the start of the investigation phase before using any actions. So we'll advance the pit. So recognition. Spawn the set aside amalgam enemy, engage with the lead investigator. Shuffle each set aside copy of blind sense and from the depths into the encounter deck along with the encounter discard pile. Shuffle each of the set aside tidal tunnel locations together to form a tidal tunnel deck, including the set aside altar of Dagon Iron Chamber and the sealed exit locations. Put locations from the top of the tidal tunnel deck into play below to the left to the right of each revealed location. Read flashback 1 in the campaign guide. So I'll pause the video, do that mid-game setup, and I'll be right back. Okay, so we have set up the map with the new locations. We have the rest of the tidal tunnel deck over here. The amalgam is engaged with us, and I decide to take an attack from it rather than giving it our key. When it engages, then we shuffle the rest of the encounter deck and the new cards here. And I think that is it. So we read the flashback number 1, so we have a meeting with Thomas Dawson, so that is it. So we have a full turn of dealing with the amalgam. So I think our first action will be to evade. And I'm evading 2 versus 2, so I'll go to 4 versus 2. Hope that is enough. Just hope to get rid of it and run away. And it's a 0, so the amalgam is evaded. Put it here. Second action, we'll just... I think we'll start moving this way. So we get a tidal pool location, 2 new locations over here and over here. We still have 2 left, so not that many. Hopefully we can find everything we need. So there is 1 clue here, there is 1 of these random keys over here. And I think the last action will be just to investigate. So it is not partially or fully flooded, so it's only strata 3. So we are investigating 2, 3, 4, 5 versus 3. I think that is good enough. It's a minus 2, so it is a pass. We get this clue. We also get this key, so it's a purple key. And that is our turn. No enemy actions, we go to upkeep, amalgam readies, we draw a card, we get another guts, and we gain 1 resource. And also we got 1 resource from Milan, so let's not forget about that. So that is that turn, let's go to the next turn. We add a doom, we are at 5 of 7, encounter card is a swarm of rats, so we need to deal with those. I think we're just punching them. So we lose this card, and we draw a card. Deduction. I think I'm placing the... I'm just putting 1 of the guts underneath here, because just in case we need... need willpower for the next phase, so next Mythos phase. So first action will punch the rats. We are punching 2 versus 1, so not that good of an odd, but it is what it is. It's a skull, it's a -1, -2 if your location is partially flooded or fully flooded, it's a -3. So we hit and kill the rats. Second action, let's keep moving. I'll move over here. And it's the Altar of Dagon. Three shrouds, zero clues. If investigators Altar of Dagon control the blue key or three or more other keys, they may spend 2 clues as a group take control of the set aside green key. So we need to come back here later. So we'll put this location and this location in play. And actually we'll go down this time, or yeah, let's go down. Okay, so it's the, we got really lucky with these two. So we need the green key to leave. So now we just need to find a location with the one more key, so we can go here and get that. Now we have the clues already, so we just need one key to get this green key to leave. So I think we could make it out. But yeah, this is fully flooded. We can't stay here. So enemy phase, the amalgam hunt, so we'll hunt over here. We'll keep it not moving towards us that much. So that is the enemy phase. We go to upkeep, we draw a card, cryptographic cipher, gain one resource, and that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add a doom and counter card is from the depths. If the amalgam is in the depths, put it into play, engage with you. Otherwise, place the amalgam in the depths and from the depths gain search. So this searches, I'll put this here. So this is in the depths, so I'll just put it on like this. And it searches into Memory of Oblivion. We are testing willpower, so 4. I think I'm spending the other guts. So 4, 6 versus 4. -4, we still fail and lose 2 cards, so lose these 2. And yeah, that sucks. Well, at least we boosted it a lot, so we didn't lose the deduction. So, investigation phase, we lose that card, we draw a card, we'll just put the deduction here. Okay, so not a really interesting turn coming, so I think we're moving up here. Moving up here. Okay, so there are 2 clues here, but I think we are not staying here. So the move, and we'll move back here. Because we don't need the clues, we need keys. So enemy phase, this hunts here. Nothing else. Upkeep, we draw a card, we get working hunch, and gain one resource. So that was that turn. Let's go to the next turn. Okay, so we are at 7 doom of 7. So this advances. Just a moment. Let's see. So increase the flood level of each revealed location. Until the end of the game, each time a location is revealed, increase its flood level. Keep this card next to the action deck as a reminder and advance to agenda 2A. So again, we have the flooding thing. If we're in a fully flooded location and won't leave during the turn, we'll take a lot of damage. So just basically add flood tokens everywhere. But yeah, and I actually forgot this come into play partially flooded. It hasn't affected our game in any way. Let's flood the rest of these revealed locations. Okay. The Mythos phase starts, so our big drawer encounter card, and it is Dreams of Relay, so minus one willpower and minus one sanity, and nothing we can do about that. Investigation phase starts, we draw a card. I think I'm just putting deduction here. And let's move over here. Okay, it's a tidal pool, so we get the clue here. And just to not fail any tests, so I'll just spend two play the working hunch, grab this clue, grab this key, move back here. So next turn we can spend, oh yeah, this location also flawed. So next turn we can spend an action to get the green key, move that down here and resign. So we should be okay. And oh yeah, this isn't in play, so no enemy movements. We'll go to upkeep. We draw a card. Amnesia. We'll just discard this. Amnesia didn't hit us that bad because we lost our big hand earlier. So that's okay. And we gain one resource. So that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add a doom. Encounter card is Fractured Consciousness. Test Intellect 3. And we'll take damage if we fail. So I'm not spending anything, so I have intellect with the deduction. I have intellect 4 against 3, so of course we fail. If you fail and the amalgam is in the depths, put it into play, engage with you. So we take 2 damage. And the amalgam engages us. Well, well, isn't this bad? So we were nearly doing really well, but then everything went to the crapper. So I'll just let this guy attack me. So one damage away from dying. That is not good. Oh well, we don't want to give it a key, so that is why I'm doing this. So okay. Start of the investigation phase, we draw a card, a flashlight, nothing helpful. We will put the overpower down underneath here. Could just punch, but that is risky, so instead I am evading. I'm using all of these resources, so I'm evading. 6 versus 2. So even the minus 4 doesn't fail us. It's a minus 1. The amalgam is evaded. Second action. We'll use the 2 clues. So we grab this green key. Last action, we'll move down here. That is our turn. Enemy phase, nothing happens. Upkeep, the amalgam readies. We draw a card. And we gain one resource. So, that is that turn. We just need to survive for the next turn and get signs. That is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add a doom. Hopefully we don't hit a bad encounter card. Let's see what we get. God. So, deep one assault. Each deep one enemy at the location and each connecting location engages you. If no enemy engages you, this card can search. So, luckily, we can just give this guy one of our keys. So, grab this key and that is that. And then, start of the investigation phase, we draw a card. Okay, we'll just put this underneath here. Then we will just resign. So, luckily we didn't take any damage, because that would have killed us. If we take 2 damage, only can solve one for Christopher, Milan Christopher. So, yeah. Even as this seemed really easy, just in a moment, like a couple of turns before we got out, we were nearly dead. So this is a punishing scenario, but with high speed investigating. Investigator, you can get the clues and advance faster than the game can dish out enemies and stuff like that your way. So, of course, we didn't get those flashbacks that give you a lot of experience at the resolution. So, we got out, so we get the resolution 1. I won't go into much detail about the resolution or the story behind this campaign, because this is such a new one. But you really want to find locations that have the flashbacks. So there's one, and there were one here. So if we would have taken this route or something like that, then we could have revealed those flashbacks and gotten more experience, but I'm happy just to get out. This is a really punishing scenario, and in true solo, you rather want to get out fast or risk failing and getting defeated. But yeah, hope you guys like this playthrough. This might be the last playthrough of this series, because the next campaign box won't be a deluxe box. It will be the full player cards from that cycle in one box. So I think this series is not necessary for the campaign boxes coming from this point forward. So I'll think something else for those. But still, this was a fun series to do. Hope you guys learned something new and got some ideas from my plays. So thanks for watching, and until next time.